Hi everybody, it's Athena Silver, psychic medium, intuitive healer, pagan minister, and witch. I want to say hi to everybody today and welcome you back. Today I really feel called to talk about patience and self-care and, you know, balance, especially an emotional balance during this time right now. I've noticed for the past week, about a week and a half, people have really been a little bit ruder than usual. I think it's because everybody's locked up, tempers are, you know, running a little high. People are feeling cooped up, being out of work and being at home and having to stay right there with everybody, kids included. You know, I think it's starting to wear in on everybody, which is why I feel called to talk about this today. The need for us to meditate and to take some time out for ourselves and really get in tune with who we are on our inside self. That's the self that you hear talking in the back of your head when you're watching TV going, come on, girl, you should have ran. That's the you. That's the real you. That's the you that tells you when, you know, you're in a bad neighborhood and it's time to go, or that you need to hold on to your pocketbook a little tighter because, you know, there might be thieves going on. You know, that inner self needs a break sometimes, you know, especially when, you know, we got kids, we've got families and households we got to take care of, we're working. Some of us are working from home for the first time in our lives. You know, there's a lot of cabin fever going on and a lot of people miscommunicating and not really taking emotions into, you know, sensitive emotions into play here. They're not taking it into consideration. You know, and I think it's just time for us to recalibrate and ground and balance. You know, what I like to do, especially during the spring, summer, and fall months, is I like to go outside barefoot and dig my feet into the grass and walk around and just kind of inhale good air and exhale any negativity out through my feet into the ground. You know, Mother Earth is there to help receive and neutralize this energy. You know, she's here welcoming us to, you know, release that negative energy and to take in positive energy in its place. Another thing I like to do, especially, you know, it's really more of a winter and summer, well, it's all year round, but typically in the winter and spring, I feel I find myself doing it the most, and that's meditating. And it's meditation with a purpose, going in and removing myself from all the distractions of what's going on around me. I have two young children, so when I get a little bit overwhelmed, instead of having to leave or having to, you know, freak out on people, I go into meditation and I go and I imagine that I'm in a dark stairwell and I'm walking down the stairs into my heart. And it's a heart-shaped door at the end of the stairs. And when I open up that heart-shaped door, I'm in my heart space. And from there, I can go wherever I need to, you know, whether that's, you know, to a beautiful forest or a deserted island with pina coladas and nobody for miles. Yeah, you know, wherever you got to go, whatever place appeals to you, you know, we all have our own individual needs. So, you know, I'll go there when I need to, you know, when I need to decompress and when I need to take time off and it's not, you know, physically available. You know, I also, something that I've been finding that I've been doing lately throughout this quarantine is I've been drinking herbal tea, which is, if you know me, not something that I'm known for. I've been getting my tea on. I grow fresh herbs, especially during the spring and summertime. So I've been getting heavy into gardening. So now I have this surplus that I can harvest from and make beautiful teas with, you know. Chamomile is one of my favorites, especially when you're feeling cabin fever and stressed out. It just takes you down another notch, you know. It chills you out, it evens you out, you feel like, oh, I can breathe again, you know. And if that's what you need when you're going through this quarantine, you know, there's just so much stressful energy. You know, everybody's worrying about their finances and the economy and their health and, you know, what the world is going to be like when all of this is done. When they're not realizing that they got to take a deep breath, they got to ground, they got to prepare for that next chapter. It's not something that we can just, you know, run right into. It's something that we need to set our intentions and walk forward into consciously. This way we get to create the future that we want, you know, where we have a say, where we're co-creating, where, you know, we're the authors of our destiny and where we want to go. You know, I have been doing a lot of journaling and thinking during this time, especially about my intentions for what comes next and what I want, you know, this next chapter of my life to look like. You know, and it's really given me a lot of time to think, a lot of perspective, you know, a lot of time to collect myself and realize, you know, all right, I was doing good before, but now I need to up the game. I need to figure out where my weaknesses are and I need to work on them so that when everything goes back to normal, I'm stronger than ever. I'm like a brick wall, you know. So give it some thought, give it some time and, you know, meditate on it. You know, meditation is the great. It's like having a piece of blank paper and a pencil, you know, you get to write and create whatever you'd like. So take that time and really dive deep within yourself, you know. Meditation doesn't just benefit you. Trust me, it benefits everybody in your house. You know, your kids will like you better. Your husband and wife will like you better. You know, your partner's going to appreciate you because you're going to be more balanced and you're not going to be coming from a place of disconnection or miscommunication. You're going to be coming from a place of direct intention. So what you want to get heard is heard correctly and is not taken out of context. Like, that can happen. It happens in the stressful times when we're home, you know, especially with all the outside stress. So communication is key right now, you know. So just meditate, take your time, think it over, you know, breathe, ground. Do what makes you happy. Do the things that are going to give you peace, balance, and joy. And I'm always here for you. I'm always here for you. And if you ever need anything, you know, reach out to me. I've been doing these awesome videos. And if you guys have any spiritual questions or any kind of, you know, metaphysical questions, you know, comment, direct message, email us, you know. Me and my team are really interested in hearing from you guys and hearing what kind of videos you want to hear about and see, you know. I'm also going to be a part of an online fair called the Awaken Fair. I'm going to be one of the readers. I'm going to be posting the information up in the next day or two about how to pre-book a reading with me. I'm going to put the links up for you, you know, in the next couple of days, so keep an eye out for them. If you pre-book, I believe they give you a discount. And if you come the day of, I think it's a different rate. So, I will link all the information on my page for all of you to see. Well, I just want to wish you guys the best. Much love and positivity always, you know, from the bottom of my heart. I wish all of you the best. You know, have a good rest of your day. I'll talk to you guys soon. Bye.